for people who are a year into the business or 2 years in the business, I would rather you get experience talking to people and get good at your craft before you try to launch a business, because they're two separate things. Getting good at your craft, talking to people, getting them at rest, knowing your camera in and out, all those things is one complete skill set. Mm. And we've all heard stories about people who have that skill set, right? And then you hear that they're awful to work with. Well, those are people who haven't taken the next step and say, I need to also be good with people.
It's true.
If you're an introvert, it's one of those things that you need to find whatever space it is. You need to know that this is literally a key. It is a key that you have to possess. It's like in the Matrix with the key maker. Without that key, you can't get past, you can't get through to success. So if you're an introvert and it's not in your nature to work with people, you need to find whatever psychological space to get there.
Right.
You have to, because people will not open up to you if there's no reciprocation.
So if you tend to be an introvert.
I'm an extrovert for sure.
I just mean person.
Oh, if you, sorry.
I sense that you're an extrovert.
I don't know if you know this, but I'm an extrovert. Just putting that down. Write it down if you want. Put it in your wallet and review a couple days a week. Jeff is an extrovert.
I believe that. But if someone is an introvert, if that's who you're addressing but they really want to get into photography, or they really want to become more of a photographer, and they're terrified of sales.
Yeah, sales and phone calls. I'm sorry.
Well,
that's another discussion, but
they're, in a lot of ways, they're very similar, because you're interacting with the client outside of the shoot.
Right.
And if someone is struggling with that, and I've talked to a few people that do, what do you say to them?
So my advice on it is funny, because I'm not an introvert. So when I say this, I'm not picking on people. I'm not saying you're wrong for feeling that way. The truth is I don't want to say it's a condition. It's a personality type that I can't exactly understand, right? Just like someone who's an introvert can't exactly understand how I can be in a room of 2,000 people and leave feeling great, like, and talk and talk and talk. Other people who are introverts say this, I have to, you know, take 2 weeks off and and snuggle, because it's too much.
Right.
So for me,
that's true. I'm more introverted than extroverted.
Yeah, I believe that's true. And we get
and
along.
Snuggling sounds really better.
Yeah, snuggling is better. So we're going to pause this for a little bit of snuggle time. Is that what
we
need to do?
No, there's other caveats
that
come along with it. But when you bring up a room of 2,000 people and I envision that, I think, ooh. And then you bring up snuggling, I think, oh. Nice.
Yes, the ooh is better than
but the snuggling is with my children or my wife.
Well, that's a whole. No. That's a,
if you
that's
said snuggling with you, I'd be like ooh again.
Yeah, that's the ooh. So there's ooh, ew, and
ew. Those are
all different things going on. But so for me, getting back to your question,
yes,
if you understand that this is the only way, like there's only one way through this, and it's through. Mm. So like if I told you you're only going to survive this calamity by throwing the only way you can survive this calamity is by throwing a chair through this window and jumping four stories. That's your only chance of survival.
You're going to do it.
You have to do it.
Yeah.
And so it's not about if, like if is so crazy, like you have to do this. So I would say like anything else, if you're trying to lose weight and you don't want to work out, you start by walking a third of a mile. Mm. And then you get up to walking a mile and whatever, like you build up to it. You understand you've got some confidence. If you have struggle talking with people, you come to something like Imaging USA, you say, I'm going to introduce myself to three people this week, or three people today, or whatever's just outside your comfort zone.
Yeah.
Carol, my wife, says all the time, you know, and it's a phrase, success lies just outside your comfort zone. Mm. And so if you have a hard time introducing yourself, go do it two or three times. Mm. And then you say, let's try it five times. And then all of a sudden you're not going to build up to like, I have to introduce myself to 150 people today. After you like introduce yourself to 10 or 12 people and nothing terrible happens.
Right.
Cause it's all about fear. Right.
Yeah.
So if nothing terrible happens, then you say, okay, I actually can do this.
Yeah.
And I now have experience having good interactions
some of those aren't going to go well.
No, someone will be like, hey, I'm Jeff. Great to meet you. Where are you from?
Right.
Hey, thanks for being here. Great.
Right.
Blah, blah, and goodbye. Like, that's a perfectly great exchange.
Hey, guys. Thanks for watching this conversation presented by White House Custom Color on YouTube. Be sure to check out our other content and click that subscribe button right there. Right. Right there. It's.
there somewhere.